Hi children, good morning. Welcome to my class. Now we are learning our third chapter, Parts of a Plant. In my previous video, we have already discussed about root and types of root. In today's video, we are going to learn about stem and leaf. So let's start today's class. The stem. The stem forms the main support of the plant. It bears branches, leaves, buds, flowers, and fruits. The stem of trees like banyan tree and neem is hard, thick, and woody. This is called trunk. The stems of herbs and shrubs are weak, thin, and green. Stem of money plant needs a support to climb. Stem of plants like pumpkin and watermelon creeps along the ground. Next, we can learn what are the functions of stem. The stem forms the main support of the plant. It helps the plant to stand erect and get sunlight and air. It carries mineral, salt, and water to different parts of the plant. It carries food prepared by the leaves to different parts of the plant. Next, we can learn about leaf. Most of the leaves are green in color because they have chlorophyll in them. Leaves of different plants differ in shape and size. Next topic. Parts of a leaf. A leaf has different parts: blade, vein, midrib, and petiole. The flattened area of the leaf is called blade. The short stems of the leaf that attach it to the main plant is called petiole. Have you ever noticed fine lines on the leaves? These fine lines are called veins. Leaf has very small holes or pores on its surface. These are called stomata. The leaves take in air through the stomata. Children, do you know? The leaf is called kitchen of the plant. Why leaves are called kitchen of the plant? Yes, leaf preparing food for plant with the help of air, water, and sunlight. That's why leaf is called kitchen of the plant. It takes in water through the roots. While preparing food, it gives out oxygen. All living things need oxygen to live. Do you know? Some plants like spinach, coriander, and cabbage, they store food in their leaves and are eaten as food. Okay. Thank you.